Hey, it's Dr. Rowe here. Just thought I'd give you a quick morning video. We have arriving on site 1,000 boards of wood this morning, so we've got a load of rearranging to do, and the message I want to just get across is plan ahead. So for example, we've got three or four extra men on site today simply because with that many boards of wood coming, we've got to reposition everything. So we've got existing wood, some of which needs to be let go, some of it we're going to hold on to. We've got space to store stuff here. So we've got 4.5 to 5 metre lengths coming in, so we're going to have to stack them here, but they will literally occupy that space. But of course, the joiners and the chippies need to do the ceiling here, so it's just working out practically how you get that many boards in a room where they're going to have a raised scaffolding area to be able to work on that part of the roof and this part of the roof. So we're making a plan at the moment, and as simple as it might appear, it's not as simple as that, because it's going to probably take 2 to 3 hours to unload all the wood, place it into the right location, stack it in a way so that there's breathing between each one to allow it to air out, and be in a room that's acclimatized to the right temperature. So we're looking at the logistics of the house and just working out what goes where. Communication very important, as you can see there. Just making sure everything's clear. The objective being that whereas these rooms had a load of stuff in them, now these rooms are going to be cleared out. We will stack in here. We've checked the temperature in this room. It is very consistent with the temperature in that room. Ambient temperature, moisture content has to be the same. Floors will sit here for a few weeks, stacked, and then moved from here and into the other room. The big question with all these things is double handling. So we've got Shane in here. Give us a wave, Shane. Shane in here, you remember Shane from before, some of you. he's organising all the stacking of stuff in there. So all of the bits and bobs, we've got a lot of stuff in here, electrics. What else we got there? Tiles. All this stuff needs to come out. So we've got two clear rooms here. This becomes then the entryway for wood coming in stacked, and then as the joiners need it, it'll be moved out into here. The biggest concern we've got is if everything's stacked in here, every time they need to do something in this room, they're going to have to literally move stuff around, which we want to try and avoid, because that means bringing more people to site, and that's more cost. So the whole point is managing the labour force, the team on site, versus the materials. There is potential storage for up there, but the challenge with going up there is then you've got to bring 5 metre lengths of wood up into there and then bring it back down again. Whereas the obvious thing, although it might involve a bit more work at the moment, is actually clearing the space down here. So the choice was to bring Ryan, who's project managing everything, up on site today and actually go through it, so we've got a clear plan, as opposed to doing it over the phone, which we originally started to do. But when you're on site, it's a very different experience. Also, we've got some cutting to do here today, so we need to remove about 60 mil of the front of this on to put this fireplace on here. So he's got his equipment there, but of course we've got the wood coming. That's going to create a lot of dust. So these are things just to be mindful of when you're in the workspace. How do you do that? They're going to use dampening and some screening to do that. But that all has to be done timely enough ahead of the wood coming, which could be any time today, and we don't know how. We haven't been given deliberate time. So the key message, I think, with all these things is make sure that you've got the communication really clear, move all the egos aside, and just get on with a plan of action and then execute the plan. Speak to you later.